struggle for control of Syria plays out in isolated battles each day. Anti-government protesters vent their anger at President Bashar al-Assad's regime. Government forces respond with overwhelming force. Hundreds have died in the past few days, and the United Nations remains on the sidelines, blocked by Russia and China's Security Council vetoes. So the United States is looking elsewhere to provide humanitarian relief for Mr. Assad's opponents and to pressure countries to stop military support for him. State Department spokeswoman Victoria Nuland.
We're going to have to take measures outside the UN to strengthen and deepen and broaden the international community of pressure on Assad.
Germany is among a so-called Friends of Syria group that's committed to ending President Assad's campaign of violence. German Foreign Minister Guido Westerwelle.
The sanctions in Europe will be tightened. We will initiate a contact group of the Friends of a Democratic Syria.
Turkish Prime Minister Tayyip Erdogan says the group is working to restore peace and stability in Syria.
We are taking advantage of every diplomatic opportunity to focus the international community on Syria.
Dünya kamuoyunun dikkatini Suriye üzerinde topluyoruz.
We are going to start a new initiative with those countries that stand by the Syrian people, not the Syrian government.
Yeni bir girişimi de bu noktada başlatacağız. Bunun da hazırlıklarını yapıyoruz.
President Assad has his own friends group, including Iran, along with Russia and China. Foreign policy analyst Malu Innocent from the Cato Institute Research Group says Tehran sees the fight over Syria's future as a threat to its influence.
So there's a fracturing within the region along not just geopolitical but also religious and sectarian lines. And this is the way Iran sees their power sort of expanded within the region. And once we see the al-Assad regime sort of topple, the Iranians are sort of left with fewer allies in the region.
Aaron Snipe is the U.S. Deputy Assistant Secretary of State for Near Eastern Affairs. He says Iran's support for Damascus puts it on the wrong side of history.
We, the international community, want to be on the right side of history. The Middle East is changing drastically, and old regimes that once stood are no longer. And what Iran is doing is siding with an old regime, a regime that is trying to cling to power in the most violent way.
Even as the killing continues, U.S. officials will not say whether Washington's support for President Assad's opponents extends to the rebel Free Syrian Army, echoing President Barack Obama's insistence that the conflict be resolved without outside military intervention. Scott Stearns, VOA News, the State Department.